Clinical Data Interchange Standards Consortium CDISC, part 204. I'm John McKeeby. I'm the Chief Information Officer of the Clinical Center of the National Institutes of Health. We're going to review the standards presented by CDISC. So this is my interpretation of all the various standards presented by CDISC. It starts with plan, collect, organize, and analyze, as well as has the data exchange between the various phases. And so it starts with planning. It has a protocol representation model based on a controlled terminology. And then collection, we'll review CDASH, we'll review the operational data model, as well as the lab data model. And then organization, we'll review the study data tabulation model and all the different components. And then the analysis data model, which is referred to as ADAM. CDISC starts with a foundational set of standards. It's a suite of data standards is to enhance quality, efficiency, and cost effectiveness of clinical research. It focuses on core principles for defining data standards, and it includes models, domains, and specifications for data representation. CDISC has foundational standards for non-clinical studies as well as clinical studies. SEND, or Standard of Exchange of Non-Clinical Data, is the implementation of study data tabulation for non-clinical studies. It specifies collection and presentation of non-clinical data and is required by the FDA for new drug applications. Foundational studies standards include protocol representation model, clinical data acquisition standards harmonization, study data tabulation model, study data tabulation model implementation guide, analysis data model, and questionnaires, ratings, and scales. We'll review each of these. The protocol representation model is a standard for planning and designing a research study. Study characteristics of study design, eligibility criteria and requirements, investigators, research type, clinical study type are all part of the study characteristics. Protocol representation model supports clinicaltrials.gov, the World Health Organization registries, and many other registries of clinical trials. Clinical Data Acquisition Standards Harmonization, CDASH, is a standard way to collect data in a similar way across studies and sponsors. It provides collection formats and structures that provide clear traceability. It provides consistency, traceability, automation, and adoption. Its principles are metadata will be organized into logical groups. Traceability for related variables will be reflected in the variable metadata, allowing the same variable to be referenced in the same way across studies. Data collection standards must be fit for purpose for all stakeholders. Concepts must be the same in both data collection and tabulation using the same controlled terminology. Question, test, and prompt must accurately match the CDASH definition of the variable. Study data tabulation model, CDTM. It's a standard way for organizing and formatting data for collection, management, and analysis and reporting. It's required by the FDA as well as PMDA for Japan for new drug applications. Again, it provides consistency, traceability, automation, and adoption. It ensures that CDTM is the first class. The most important modeling decision point is at the beginning, reviewing interventions, events, findings, and findings about. It aligns with the CDTM variable definition. Every variable must have a clear definition to achieve structural standardization. It aligns semantics. Every data element should have a clear definition to achieve semantic standardization. It's important to represent each concept in the same domain. It's important to preserve the original meaning, but standardize the presentation. And consider the impact of any changes that you make in meaning or definition of any variable. The standard data tabulation model has an implementation guide. This reviews that standard. This standard guides the organization's structure and format of standard clinical trial tabulation data sets. Again, it's required by the FDA and PMDA of Japan. It publishes the set of rules and ensures that they are identified. The principles are to make consistent decisions, provide timely support, and assess change impacts. Analysis data model, ADAM. It defines the data set and metadata standards for analysis. It supports efficient generation, replication, and review of clinical trial statistical analysis. Again, it's required by the FDA and PMDA of Japan. The principles are to make consistent decisions, provide timely support, and assess change impacts. Questionnaires, ratings, and scales. It's a series of questions, tasks, or assessments used in clinical research. It provides a qualitative or quantitative assessment of clinical concept or task-based observations. It's based on a controlled set of terminology as well as the SDTM tabulation supplements. CDISC has a set of therapeutical area user guides. It reviews the variables, control terminology, questions for specific therapeutic areas. And below is a set of those therapeutical areas, from acute kidney injury to COVID-19, to diabetes, to Crohn's disease, to kidney transplant, pediatrics, rare diseases, to vaccines, to virology. And then controlled terminology. It's a set of code lists and valid values used with data items within CDISC defined data sets. It provides values required for submission to FDA and PMDA in CDISC compliant data sets. The operational data model. It facilitates regulatory compliant acquisition, archive, and interchange of metadata and data. Again, it's vendor neutral, platform independent format for interchange and archival. It has three parts: metadata, which describes the electronic case report form; admin data, which contains references to users' locations and any non-clinical reference data; and then clinical data, containing all electronic case report form item values and references both metadata and admin data. Define XML. It's implemented using the CDISC operational data model XML schema. It supports the interchange of dataset metadata for clinical research applications in a machine-readable format. It supports other CDISC standards to ensure the integration and interchange to regulatory authorities. The key metadata components of Define XML are dataset definition, variable definitions, the use of controlled terminology, value list definitions for the controlled terminology, links to supporting documents, computational method definitions, and comment definitions. CDISC also utilizes standards across the world. It utilizes HL7, the base definition for HL7, HL7 RIM, as well as FHIR. It uses DICOM, or based on DICOM, which is the standard for communication and management of medical imaging information. Utilizes MEDRA for identifying individual medical events. It utilizes ICD-10, which is commonly used terminology worldwide. It uses LOINC, which is the laboratory and clinical codes used for lab instruments and lab tests. Also utilizes SNOMED CT, which provides definitions across diseases. And it utilizes Unified Medical Language System, which is a collection of over 100 controlled vocabularies in biomedicine and health. In collaboration with CDISC, the Biomedical Research Integrated Domain Group model was created. It utilizes standards from CDISC, the International Organization for Standardization, standards from the National Cancer Institute, and from the FDA. CDISC standards harmonized with Bridge include SDTM, CDISC lab model, statistics, CDASH, as well as trial design model. Ways Bridge is used. Bridge can be used as a reference model, identifying the foundation model to represent research domain across stakeholders. It can validate requirements and communicate ideas about research goals, function, and data use. It can be used as the data integration mapping solution. It can serve as the primary standard mapping across standards. So it can bridge across LOINC to ICD-10 to SNOMED, different concepts and different codes. It can be the exchange format. It can be used as data exchange format utilizing XSD and XML format to various regulatory organizations as well as across research organizations. It can be a physical database. It can be used to create logical and physical database model. And then ontology, it can serve as a resource for developing a clinical or translational research ontology. So this is my interpretation of CDISC and the Bridge models. So part of the Bridge model includes the NCI Enterprise Vocabulary Services. It includes the Bridge model itself. It allows the use of CDISC, the various items for terminologies, protocol definition, the clinical data acquisition standards harmonization components, the study data tabulated model as weighted way as data analysis. It allows exchange of data to clinical trials as well as FDA. This shows the database logical model for implementing the study data tabulation model and the protocol representation model within Bridge. This shows all the various tables and the interconnection of those tables with inside a database. And this is an example of the CDISC lab data model implemented within Bridge within its database, again showing the data tables as well as the interrelationship between those tables. So this is the entity relationship model of the CDISC lab data model within Bridge.